So be staged here over the weekend of the 13th and 14th of April. Eight teams involved in the Axiata Cup. Every team has to play every other team to determine the final league table. And that's how it stands after six matches. Of course, today, the last chance to add points to your team score. Now, the difference from yesterday is that Europe and Asia have swapped places. Of course, Asia yesterday, a good win for them against Singapore. For love, their victory, and it's leapfrogged them over the European team. So, of course, Malaysia against Asia is absolutely vital because the fourth qualifying place for the semi-final stage is up for grabs, and these are two of the teams hoping to qualify. Well, as you can see, there are four matches per tie: women's singles, men's singles, mixed doubles and men's doubles. And if you've been with us in the earlier stages, you will know that every single match won within the tie is a point towards the team's score. So it's not just a matter of winning the tie, it's every match counts. Well, this is the Malaysia's players' lounge. They were all looking very relaxed a little earlier, of course, fresh from their 4-love victory yesterday evening against Vietnam. And there, Chong Wei Feng being rested for today's match against the Asia All-Stars. Liu Darren has got the selection for today's men's singles. But I have to say, the Malaysian team and the youngster Sonia Cheah have put up a very, very good showing here on home soil in Kuala Lumpur. That was Sonia Cheah yesterday against Vietnam. All the players performing well, and I thought that Chong Wei Feng was growing in confidence with every match he's played in this Axiata Cup. But he did say after this match yesterday that his legs were heavy, he was feeling tired, and that's possibly why he's been replaced in the men's singles by Liu Darren. Well, it was a surprise selection in the mixed doubles yesterday, and I suspect that that was to rest the top Malaysian mixed doubles pair. This, the Asian All-Stars, a little earlier, just a few moments ago, when they arrived in their players' rat lounge, ready for the team talk from team manager and coach Greg Kim. And they, of course, will be delighted that they have moved up one place in the league table from fifth yesterday. Now they're up to four, and they are, in fact, two places ahead of Europe. So they're looking good, but they're not secure of their place, and they all know it. They've probably been discussing all the permutations of what if Europe were to beat Indonesia. Indonesia, of course, head of the table. So it's a tall order in Surabaya for Europe to beat the hosts, Indonesia. But it is possible, and therefore they've all been talking about what needs to be done. Well, I can tell you, as far as the Asian All-Stars are concerned, well, Tai Tzu Ying only came into the second stage of the round robin contest because, of course, the first four matches were played last week, all of them in Surabaya. This week, of course, it's split in two venues. Four teams remain in Surabaya, four have come here to Kuala Lumpur. And the Asia All-Stars, five different countries involved in their team. Well, the first of our matches in this Malaysia against Asia, this crucial tie, is women's singles. Sonia Cheah for Malaysia, Tai Tzu Ying for the Asia All-Stars. Sonia Cheah makes her way onto center stage. Lost her match against Guduan from Singapore on Friday. Yesterday, needed three games to beat the Vietnamese Vu Thi Trang. Tai Tzu Ying has also only been involved since the second stage of the round robin contest here in Kuala Lumpur. On Friday, she beat the Vietnamese player. Yesterday, she beat Gu Juan of Singapore in three games. And it goes without saying, doesn't it, that to get your team off to a winning start, absolutely vital to set the tone as far as the match, rest of the matches are concerned. So, Tai Tzu Ying against Sonia Cheah. 19-year-old from Malaysia against an 18-year-old from Taipei. This will be the first time that these two players have met each other. And both of them huge talents for the future in the game. Well, in fact, Tai Tzu Ying has already won four titles, two of them Super Series events, the Japan Open last year and here in Malaysia last year, earlier this year. So to Sonia Cheah, 46 in the world ranking, the 19-year-old. And until she reached the final of the Dutch International last year, a couple of semi-finals last year as well. This year, a quarter-final, that was at the Austrian International. So to the 18-year-old from Taipei, number 9 in the world ranking, and this her highest ever world ranking position. So both players have been heavily involved this week in Kuala Lumpur, but Sonia Cheah has certainly made a big impression, and she was asked a little earlier about her prospects in this match against Tai Tzu Ying.
Basically, the Taiwanese girl, I never played with her before, so but I will try my best to play today. But because she's a more experienced player and she's a top player also, so I would like to learn from her and gain more experience and play well. I will try to play well in my game today and help my team to. Hope to win a point.
Well, that's a very good attitude, isn't it? Just eager to learn from the experience. Of course, no pressure on her because nobody's expecting her to win. I have a feeling that given opportunities like this, that Sonia Cheah is going to improve in leaps and bounds. Highly talented individual. As indeed is Tai Tzu Ying. Tai Tzu Ying, of course, reached her first Super Series tournament final when she was a 15-year-old, having battled through the qualifying of the Singapore Super Series in 2010, turned 16 on finals day. Ever finalist, I believe, in a Super Series tournament. So Crystal Tan from Malaysia, our umpire, calls for play to get underway. Well, I did think Tai Tzu Ying in her match yesterday when Asia played against Singapore and she was playing against Gu Juan, I thought she was a little bit sluggish to get going. I wonder if she's learned from that experience and will be able to find her form earlier in the match. Well, there's the two Malaysian coaches, Wan Tat Meng and Rashid Sadek, was nearest to us. Well, nice idea. But wrong execution. Always looks as if she hasn't a care in the world. She certainly does, I can assure you of that. Oh, trademark shot that. Oh, that is beautiful play from Sonia Cheah. Nice. Well, very interesting that Bao Chun Lai there, sitting on the coaching bench for the Asia All-Stars team. Nice singles. And of course, Bao Chun Lai, former top men's singles player from China. 3 medals from World Championships. Oh. Just sensational. The disguise on that. The racket skills are absolutely superb. Easy, relaxed hitting motion. Is the control of the front of the court, the net play. Who can get to the net front first? Because already in these very early stages, we've witnessed both players, when they take the shuttle early, racket arm outstretched at the front, they both can play good tight spinning net shots, and they both have this disguised little hold and flick deep into court. So that's going to be the key. Who gets to the net first? Who controls that area? Just missed it. Yeah, didn't miss by much. Well, I've been talking all week about the drift in this arena. There is a slight sideways drift going from left to right as we look down on the court. There we go, from left to right. And a lengthways drift. Shuffle tends to fly a little faster coming towards us as well. Good rally. Yeah, there's the hold and flick on the backhand side from Sonia Cheah. Just wide. Again, a nice idea. Now, Sonia Cheah just telling the umpire, Crystal Tan, that somebody is taking photographs with a flashlight and it's disturbing her. The offender sitting just in front of me. He'll get a severe telling off a little later. Can see the tournament referee coming up here to have a word with him. Yeah, clever serve. Use of a flick, a much flatter trajectory. Just rushing Sonia Cheah into the shot, and therefore she made the error. Well, we watched her yesterday against Booty Trang. She was 14-7 up in the second game, having won the first, Sonia Cheah. And then a whole series of errors. They looked to be in command, and then promptly lost that game 21-18. So we know that there's a possibility that she struggles to keep her absolute focus throughout the entirety of the game. That said, we've got to give credit to Tai Tzu Ying, who's just played a couple of very good points. It's going wide. This time the little hold and flick was just too flat. Not deep enough. Here it comes, trying to push it deep into the forehand corner. And Sonia Cheah, very alert to it. Drift air conditioning on here at this Kuala Lumpur stadium, and the air conditioning undoubtedly does cause more of a drift, moves the shuttle. So it is the Malaysian who has the advantage at the mid-game interval. Two-point advantage, to be precise. Hit the top of the tape, but fell back her side. Tapping. Very experienced coach. Delightful gentleman. He always comes and chats to me and tells me what's going on with the team. And I have to say, the Malaysian coaches have done a wonderful job with this youngster. He's improving all the time. Taking it early at the net. Both of them have these such good push shots from the net area. Oh yes, well constructed rally. Push deep into the forehand corner, then immediately going for the attacking shot across court, and that makes the opponent twist and turn. So for the first time in this opening game, Tai Tzu Ying goes into the lead. Lovely shot again, great length on that push just inside the back line. Yeah, perfect. Oh. of 4 points comes to an end. From Sonia Cheah, really moving her opponents, using all four corners of the court. Deep backhand, then attacks down the forehand side, and then deep backhand once again. Ooh, it's just wide. A long, hard look from Tai Tzu Ying towards the line judge. Oh, I thought she could have killed that. Oh, magnificent. What a shot. Punishing rally. Both players taking the opportunity to have a little towel down, take on board some liquid. Next three or four rallies, I suspect, will be absolutely crucial. And that really is a gift at this stage of the match. Error on the return of serve, push too long. Got to think about the drift. Oh, it's called just wide. Tai Tzu Ying doesn't like the call. Oof. Wow, goodness me, I'd hate to be a line judge. Landed in. Yeah, it's a delightful little block from the smash towards the body. Sonia Cheah just swaying the sort of her body out of the way to play that shot. Oh, well taken. Goodness me. Is magnificent control. Oh, women's singles players women's singles discipline in general has really, really improved, become more and more skillful. Really not an awful lot of difference between women's singles and men's singles now, with the skills and the shots and the athletic ability. Of course the men are a little bit stronger, but oh, another misjudgment. It's landed in again. So precious at this stage of the game. 18 all. It's a good rally. Error on the net shot from Tai Tzu Ying. Look how low she's taking it. That, I surmised early on, would be the key. You've got to take it early. And Sonia Cheah took it much earlier at the front of the court in that last rally. Hence, two game point opportunities. She converts on a run of four straight points from 17-18 down. Closes out the opening game 21-18. And Malaysia are off to exactly the start they wanted. Yes, the final rally. No good looking at the racket. Tai Tzu Ying didn't get her feet in position. That's why she made the error. Coaches look relaxed. She looks relaxed. And why not when you've won the opening game, 21-18.
Okay, I'm here with Zeti, who is a badminton supporter. So Zeti, what do you think of the first set when Sonia's win?
Okay, well, I think it's very competitive between them two, but I can see that Malaysia have very good potential to win this game.
How much of crowd support do you think will play a role for Malaysia's win today?
Okay, obviously, because we're at our home, right? So I think that we have advantage for our player.
Okay, last question. Prediction overall, Malaysia versus Asia All-Star?
Of course, 4-0.
4-0. Okay, that's your prediction, Zeti. Okay. So we'll have to see whether it comes true or not. Back to the courts.
Well, before this match, Sonia Cheah was talking about the fact that she'd never played her opponent of today and that she was hoping to learn from it. I suspect if she carries on playing like this, it's Tai Tzu Ying who will need to learn from it. And of course, Malaysia look fairly certain to qualify for the semi-final stage. They're number two in the standings at the moment, 1 point behind the defending champions Indonesia. Really is a big battle between Asia and Europe as to which of those two teams will join. In all probability, Indonesia, Malaysia and Thailand. But things could change more than that. So this is absolutely vital for both teams. Swing from this shot from Sonia Cheah, just tries to get a racket basically in the way and flick the shuttle back. Quicker feet needed. Return of serve. Mistimed that one. Wonder if it got caught in the sight line between the lights. Tai Tzu Ying, but it's always a weakness when you see a player turn deep into that backhand corner and play the backhand, because they've got their back to the net. They can't see where the opponent is, so they can't see where the court is either. To rely on spatial awareness. Yeah, what a difference when she makes the effort, move her feet to be able to play that shot with the round the head action, as we call it, rather than turning to play the backhand. This one, feet in position, can play with the normal overhead action. And she's got so many more options. Towards the giant screen to see the replay. Once again, that was desperately, desperately close. Again. Sonia Cheah doing exactly what was required, which was getting her opponent out of position. Yeah, I think that correct call. I think that was wide. Did very, very well, Tai Tzu Ying. Dig herself out of trouble deep in that forehand corner. See in the background there, Bao Chun Lai urging his teammate on. Shows the disappointment. Oh my goodness, why didn't she kill it? Ends up losing the rally. Oh, what an extraordinary choice of shots. She was coming forward, looked to me as if she was going to kill the shuttle. It was earlier than that, and then just for some reason decided to play the net shot. It wasn't even really a net shot, it was just a little block. Oh, that was going wide. Yeah, well, she's really lost her touch at the net, Tai Tzu Ying, at the moment, and I suspect most of that is because she's feeling under threat and under pressure from the Malaysian at the front of the court. To play the late backhand deep from court, and therefore the attempted backhand clear way too short. That left the court wide open. Look where Sonia Cheah's feet are, nowhere near the back of the court. That's the indication of how short the clear was. It is the Malaysian who has the advantage at the mid game interval, having already taken the first. Yes, a very clever smash from Tai Tzu Ying, aiming towards the right hip of Sonia Cheah. No doubt in my mind who's winning the battle at the net, and it's the young Malaysian. So often now, because she's used so many good little holds and flicks to the back of the court, she's about to play a net shot. Tai Tzu Ying is backing off from the net, which means she's not ready and not alert to a net shot. Just wide. Yeah, super play. But my goodness me, what indecision at the back of the court early on in that rally from Tai Tzu Ying. By the drift. Between success and failure, and tiny. That shuttle had a little think about going over and then fell back. Tai Tzu Ying side of the court. Oh, that's good. Good movements. Opening up a 3-point cushion at this crucial stage. Produces a winning shot like that. She has the capability, there's no doubt about it. But what's such a delight about this match is the skill level of both these players, and both of them still teenagers. Long. Well, Tai Tzu Ying, a little bit lucky there. What was that? I think Sonia Cheah was so surprised at that shot from her opponent. She was flummoxed by it and therefore hit too flat on her final shot. Oh my goodness. What a time to serve into the net. Well, there's the inexperience. And one thing you do when you're leading a more experienced opponent, an opponent who's supposed to beat you, is make them play the shuttle. Dear, dear me. Service error, then an error on the return of serve, and all of a sudden it's 18-all, and it also sends a message to your opponent that you're nervous. Don't go for the lines, just keep it simple. Give yourself margins for error. Yeah, that's better than that. Oh dear, no, it's long. Oh, I'm surprised, she's surprised. Three straight points takes Tai Tzu Ying into the lead. High serve. It's wide. Well, it's very interesting that Tai Tzu Ying is using the high serve. Normally I see her, she only ever serves short, and that's an indication of how much she thinks Sonia Cheah is a threat at the front of the court. Now that little slip there by Sonia. Yeah, it was just wide. Now, I did wonder, as the Malaysian slipped on her lunge forward, whether she turned her ankle a little, but she seems to be okay. Well, four straight points, and now two game point opportunities for Tai Tzu Ying. Recovery from Sonia Cheah. Now one of the two game points brilliantly saved. And that's long. Oh, it's called long. Sonia Cheah turns and looks to her coaches in utter disbelief. 21-19, the umpire confirms the score. Well, wouldn't mind having a closer look at that. Not sure that we'll be able to. But that is desperately close. Academic, really, as to whether it was in or out, because that confirms it is one game apiece. We will be treated to a third and deciding game now. Chen Bo having the instruction to be given to Tai Tzu Ying. So third and deciding game in the women's singles in this Axiata Cup match between Malaysia and Asia All-Stars. Sonia Cheah, having won the first 21-18 and led 18-16 in the second, two errors, an error on serve, an error on the return of serve, and all of a sudden, here we were, facing a third and deciding game. It will be very interesting to see her character and how she comes back. Certainly came back very well yesterday when Malaysia played against Vietnam, and she'd been in a winning position in her second game yesterday. She was very, very focused for the third, so certainly the signs are very good about her mental approach. Oh, good rally. Good work rate by both players. Keep the mental toughness, got to keep the discipline. Tai Tzu Ying standing very, very far forward to hit the big high serve. That's nice. Yeah. That was the one that did the damage, opened up the court, gave the opportunities. Five straight points to Tai Tzu Ying. Brilliant game. Yeah, the skill of both these players, I think they're two of the leading players in women's singles, with their deception, their little hold and flick from the net. Look at that, that's just delightful. Believe that every time I've watched Sonia Cheah, she's just got better and better. We've been talking here in Malaysia as who's going to follow on from Lee Chong Wei and his wife Wong Mu Chu. While singles is concerned, well, I think Sonia Cheah, if she continues to develop like this, will be very good successor to Wong Mu Chu.
Okay.
gone flat, it's gone long. So the Malaysian back into the lead. Difficult really to believe that she's only number 46 in the world. Why she thinks on court, array of shots, why she constructs the rallies. Touched the net there. Goodness me, wasn't called a fault. I can't believe that. Well, justice in the end, because the shot will go on long of the back line, but Sonia Cheah on her net shot there practically demolished the net. It wasn't called. Look at that. Well, we're all human, we all make mistakes, but the umpire really should have spotted that. To changing ends in the deciding game with the advantage. Ooh, any questions I had about the character of Sonia Cheah at the start of this deciding game, having been in a winning position in the second? I think we've had our answer to that. Very, very good mental approach. Well, 10-all. Perhaps a little bit dangerous to smash across courts. If your opponent does read it and play the straight block, then of course you've got the full diagonal of the court to scamper. 10-all. Now, it is indeed the Malaysian who has the advantage at the mid-game interval, as indeed she's had now in all three games. She was 11-10 up in the second at this stage. And of course 11-9 up in the first. Another opportunity missed at the front of the court from Tai Tzu Ying. first time we've seen any sort of reaction from Tai Tzu Ying. A little clenched fist after the rally. Oh, that is magnificent. A perfectly constructed point by Sonia Cheah. Deep in the forehand corner, she'd use the deep backhand corner, gradually outmaneuvering her opponent. Classic singles tactics. And this against Tai Tzu Ying, who's ranked number 9 in the world and has already won 2 Super Series titles. Now, a little bit of a discrepancy between the two players as to whether the shuttle should be changed or not. The umpire agrees with Tai Tzu Ying. And the skills to be able to implement it. Push that wide. Oh, she's really lost all confidence at the net, Tai Tzu Ying. And that is simply because her opponent keeps beating her on the net plate, is ready to pounce, and is a real threat at the front of the court. Right idea, but I have to say Sonia Cheah would have reached that anyway. She was alert to it. Yeah. Well, really has performed magnificently so far. 4-point advantage at this crucial stage, but she close it out. Of course, Malaysia look they will probably qualify for the semi-final stage. But they want to be either place one or two on the league table, because the number one and two on the league table guarantee to be either ends of the knockout draw. And they will be keen not to be in the same half as Indonesia. The only way to ensure that is to be either one or two, as it looks very much as if Indonesia will top the table. Oh, that's a good net shot. Good rally. There's certainly no lack of commitment from either of these players. And it was the punch clear there that was so good from Tai Tzu Ying, then playing the slow drop shot. Some liquid while the court is mopped after the full length dive. I don't think that the court attendant has actually mopped up quite well enough. He'll be asked to come back on. I can bring you right up to date with what's happening in Surabaya at the moment. Indonesia are one love up against Europe. Pushed it long. It's a good rally. And suddenly, Tai Tzu Ying in that last rally taking much more of the initiative. Well, match has been in progress exactly 1 hour, and you can't separate these two players. It's one game all and 17 all. What a match. Oh, it's a great rally. Yeah, the frustration from Sonia Cheah. Well, it's five straight points from 13-17 down. So now go back into the lead, Tai Tzu Ying. Oh, it's nice. Make that six straight points. I did say that she'd struggled to finish out the second game. She'd struggled in a match yesterday against the Vietnamese player when in a winning position. Won it in two games, struggled to finish it off. Surely history is not going to repeat itself again, is it? Oh, the error on the net shot, and Tai Tzu Ying on a run of seven straight points now, from 13-17 to 20-17, and three match point opportunities. That's a little over anxious to try and finish that off. Goodness. Oh, she's got it back. Would you believe it? And it's just wide. What a rally. Well, how on earth did they both keep that rally going? Badminton at its very, very best. That was sensational. Well, Tai Tzu Ying wants the shuffle changed. Sonia Cheah says no. Umpire Crystal Tan agrees with Sonia Cheah. Well, she saved two match points with his shuffle. Why would she want to change it? Third match point. And that's gone wide. What an extraordinary match. 20 all. Extra points required. And until there's a two-point difference between the two players. Goodness me, what drama, what excitement. And that's gone wide, so having saved three match points now, Sonia Cheah has a match point herself. She's done it! Would you believe it? Sonia Cheah has come back from the brink. Three match points down on a run of 5 points to take this deciding game 22-20. An hour and 6 minutes of pulsating badminton. Well, the umpire confirms the score. Well, she must be absolutely delighted.
Okay, I'm with Sonia Cheah, who gave us such a thrilling three-match performance against Team Asia All-Star. So, Sonia, what was your thought when it was the third set and it was deuce and, you know, the crowd was cheering for you and it was so close? It could have been anyone's game.
Yeah. Actually, in the third game, it would be anyone's game. So, it depends on how you control the shuttle and keep the ball in. The one that can make less mistake, the one will win.
What pulled you through in the third set? Because you could have won in the second game just now, right? But then it was dragged to the rubber. So yeah, what went through your mind?
It's due to I feel like winning already. So I feel lost patience and lost focus. So I make mistake more. Yeah.
So what are your hopes for Team Malaysia today?
Sorry?
What are your hopes for Team Malaysia today?
I hope my team will win every single point and I will support them all the way.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you again and congratulations. Thanks, Sonia.
I stay well, ladies and gentlemen, an exciting opening match.
Well, no wonder she's a very happy lady.
Taking it in the
beating a top 10 ranked player and beating her match. In style.
We got some great attitudes in the background. Let's give it to the left. Let's go. Let's go.
You know, it really was probably one of the best women's singles matches I've witnessed all year. Great skills, great drama. But in the end, Sonia Cheah has caused a major upset in beating the higher ranked player in three games. 21-18, 19-21, 22-20 in the deciding game, having saved three match points.
I am Bunyong, you are watching Axiata Cup.